Today we'll discuss about advanced encryption standard AES. So in last session we have discussed about DES, and this is another encryption algorithm called AES, widely used still nowadays. Okay, so even it is quite old, but still, you know, today it is new. Origin of the AES. It was a clear replacement for DES was needed at the time. So because attackers have theoretical, there was theoretical attack that can break the DES. That was a alarming situation for people who was using DES and have demonstrated excessive key search attack, because you know that DES is having very small key space of 64 bits. Even that 60 out of 64 bits, only 56 bits are treated as key. So very small key space. So due to that, it was vulnerable towards excessive key search. You can use triple DES, but slow with small blocks, because there is another version of DES which is triple DES. That may triple DES is nothing but you encrypt you encrypt the plain text three times with DES and with three different keys. So basically in that case attacker have to find out three different key, three DES they have to break, you can say like that. Okay, so US NIST issued call for cipher in 1997, which was a competition, open competition. 15 candidates accepted in June 98. So 15 candidate algorithms was submission was accepted for consideration to be accepted as AES. Okay, and finally five of them were shortlisted in August 99. And Rizendil was selected as AES in October 2000. And finally, they had done a little bit of modification and on the Rizendil. Rizendil was the original cipher or algorithm. Okay. And finally, they have done some modification and published in FIPS publication 197, the reference number standard, in November 2001. So in November 2001, the Rizendil is published as AES with a little bit modification. Okay. So requirements for AES, what this was the requirement was floated by NIST in the advertisement, that it should be private key symmetric block cipher. So the cipher must be block private key, and it should be a symmetric key encryption. That means the sender and receiver or encryption and decryption will use the same key. Okay, and it must be a block cipher. Okay, and it was also recommended that the minimum key size should be 128 bit, but it should have option to enhance or use key of 192 bit and 256 bit keys. Okay, and it should be stronger and faster than triple DES, because at that time triple DES was only option, or you can say the one of the best option to encrypt. So it was said that it should be stronger and faster than triple DES, and it should have active life of 20 to 30 years plus archive values. That means this AES algorithm should be such strong that it should not be broken into 30 years, at least 20 to 30 years. And during this 20 to 30 years of use, a huge amount of data is going to be encrypted, and that encrypted data is going to be stored in the different storage or hard disks or memories. So that should be that is that, because that encrypted data will be there beyond the 30 years also. So that time also is should serve. Okay, now if you think that in 2001 AES was accepted, and we are now in 2021, so it is already 20 years, and there was no good report of breaking of AES. Okay, almost nobody broken AES, and some special cases has been broken, but special cases should not be generalized as the security vulnerability of AES. Okay, now it should provide full specification and design detail. That means whoever the people design the algorithm for AES, they must provide full specification and design detail. Okay, there should not be anything hidden basically, and it should be implementable in C and Java, both the languages, because at that time in 2001, C and Java were the most popular languages. Okay, then NIST have released all submissions and unclassified analysis. That means NIST have released all the submission, that means all the candidate cipher was submitted to NIST. They have released it, and they have also released in unclassified for with unclassified analysis. That means what analysis NIST they have done, so that they have rejected the others and chosen Risendale for AES. That analysis also unclassified. That means that is also in public domain. You can search and find it. Okay. Now, what were the AES evaluation criteria? That means based on what criteria Risendale was chosen and other was rejected. First one was initial criteria, that is security, effort to practically encrypt, practically cryptanalyze. That means if somebody is trying to cryptanalyze the cipher, it should need some effort. Okay, then cost in sense of computational. That means it should not be very complex, that it will take a huge computational cost. Okay, so that should be reduced. And algorithm and implementation characteristics, so these characteristics was given by the NIST. It is not noted here. Okay, then final criteria was it should provide general security, software and hardware implementation is, that means it should be easily implementable in software and hardware. Then implementation attacks, that means it should be able to resist the attacks which are possible on it during implementation. And flexibility in encrypt and decrypt, keying and other factors. Now, AES shortlist. So I told you that five algorithms were shortlisted out of the 15. So after testing the and evaluation, shortlist in August 29 was this five algorithm. First one is Mars, proposed by IBM, which was complex, fast and had a high security margin. RC6, one group from USA was submitted. It is very simple, very fast, low security margin. Risendale was submitted from Belgium, and it was a clean design, fast computation and good security margin. Okay, and then Sharpent from Europe, which was a slow one, and a clean code was there, but a very high security margin was also there. And Twofish from USA, another algorithm, which was complex, very fast, high security margin. So based on all these criteria, it was found that Risendale is basically clean, fast, and good security margin. So complexity is later lesser, because one of the parameter for to choose, to be chosen for AES was it should have less computational overhead or complexity. So comparing all these things, Risendale was chosen. Then the subject to further analysis and comment, it was NIST has opened for that, and show contrast between algorithms with few complex round versus many simple round. So how the things was compared. the other algorithms may have, you know, complex round. Maybe they are very few round, but in AES we will find the rounds are very simple. Even they are, you know, many rounds are there, but they are simple round. Okay, refined existing cipher versus new proposals. So what are the features of AES? Designed to be efficient in both hardware and software across a variety of platform. Not a Fistel cipher network, it is not a Fistel network. Then block size is 128 bit, variable key size of 128, 90, 192 and 256 bits, and variable number of rounds. You have 10 rounds if your key is equal to 128 bit, 12 round for 192 bit and 14 rounds for 256 bits. Okay, and still now known on weaknesses. Okay, so the AES cipher are resembled designed by Resman and Damon, two different person in Belgium. Okay, has these three key options I have already told you, and this round I have already told you, and iterative rather than Fistel cipher. So it is it can be seen that this round, you know, this 10 rounds, 12 round and 14 rounds, these rounds can be imagine in a way of iterations instead of the way of thinking like Fistel cipher, you know, Fistel rounds. So that is the thing. Then it treats data in four groups and four bytes and operates an entire block in every round. So it operates an entire block in every round. Okay, now designed to be resistant against known attacks, speed and code compactness on many CPUs, and design simplicity. So these things I have already told you. Okay, so yeah, here is the structure of the cipher. If you see, it takes the plain text block, which is 128 bit, and then it goes through a add round key steps, which is basically a jar with the round key. We call these a round key. Okay, so there is an expand key. Scheme or algorithm parallelly runs, or sub algorithm basically, okay, which expands the initial 128 key and generates, you know, further 128 bit for each of the round, 10 rounds, okay, for 128 bit. So for each of the round, it expands the key and generate new keys, okay, 10 times. This is the thing. Then in every round, you will find there is a substitute bytes, shift rows, max mix the columns, and again at the end of the round there is add round key. Okay, so these boxes are, you know, the rounds are defined by these boxes, and before one first round starts, there is the first add round key operation, which is out of the round. Okay, initially it happens. Okay, and finally all these 10 rounds are having same structure. And finally, after 10 rounds, the output is called as the ciphertext. All right. And there is the decryption process. You can see the decryption process is nothing but the reverse operation. The same operations in the reverse order is happening in the decryption round, in the decryption process. Okay. So if you see, this is what I have already told you. It 128-bit long plain text block is entered. Okay, then 128-bit long private key you have. So you add the round key here. Then there, you know, in the red line, this bracket is showing you one round. In the round function, you have S box first. Then you are having shift row operation. Then mix column operation. Then add round key operation again. Okay. So here you can see that like Fistel cipher, you don't have that operation of splitting your plain text block into left right, then extending the left right part. All these things are not here. Okay, So it is very simple, you can understand. Okay. Now, here in AES, we represent the initial, the key, basically, the key and the plain text blocks in 4x4 matrix. So if you think, you know, the initial plain text block you are giving is 128 bits. Okay. So if it is 4x4 matrix, okay, that means how many elements you have? You have 16 elements, right? P0 to P15. You have 16 elements. And you have total, 128 bit to be represented, to be stored in these 16 cells. So how many bits per cell you will store? 128 by 16, okay, equal to 8. So each of these cells are P0, P1, P2, P3, and all these P's are basically going to have 8 bits or 1 byte, okay? So the plain text of 128 bit is stored as in form of bytes and 4x4 matrix. Clear how this matrix is going to be generated. The same way, initially if you have 128 bit key, that 128 bit key is going to be represented as this one byte per cell into 4 into 4, that means 16 cells. Okay, so initially what we have done, we have represented our plain text and key in 4x4 matrix. Okay, now here we have our S box. Okay, this S box is fixed for AES. So what happens if you look at this S box? The columns are numbered from 0 to F, that means hexadecimal numbering, okay? And rows are also numbered from 0 to F, okay? So in hexadecimal, you know that it can be represented in 4-bit in binary, right? So to choose or to select a row, you need 4-bit, and to select a column, you need another 4-bit. Okay, and if you see the entries in the table, all of them are hexadecimal numbers. That means every entry in this table can be represented by 8 bits, okay, as they are hexadecimal numbers. 2-digit hexadecimal number, so 8-bit you will need to represent them. Okay, so how this SBox works? You have, you know, first 8-bit after adding the round key. Okay, you have the first 8-bit. That first 8-bit, it is going to be splitted into two parts, 4-bit and 4-bit. First 4 bits are used to select a row, or used as a row index. And next 4-bit is used as column index. So if you can select a row and if you can select a column, the intersection of the row and column will give you a single cell, and we will pick whatever value is there in that cell as the output of SBox. And we know that each cell or each value in these cells in the table or SBox are representable by 8-bit. So output of this S box will be 8-bit at a time. Okay, so this will happen for all 16 bytes, and you will get 16 output from this S box. Okay, next it is goes for byte substitution. So what happens in this? This is the thing what I have explained, that is happens in the byte substitution. Okay, a simple substitution for each byte, use the one table of 16 by 16 bytes containing permutation of all 256 8-bit values. Okay, so in this table you have all 256 8-bit values, okay, and they are written in hexadecimal. Okay, so each byte of state is replaced by byte in the row, left 4-bit and column. So this is a kind of array representation. Okay, so row in bracket, left 4-bit, that is the index. Okay, and column in bracket the right forbit, which so this is the right forbit, so this is the column index. Okay, so for example, byte, say you have 95, is represented by row 9 and column 5. Okay, so row 9 is, this is the ninth row and this is the fifth column, so you will get 2a as output. Okay, so which is the value of 2a, so it will give you the value of 2a. Okay, so sbox is constructed using a defined transformation of the values in Galois field to define it. Okay, so how this sbox is constructed, they have used Galois field to the power 8 to generate this sbox. Okay, and designed to be resistant to all non-attacks. Shift rows. So in a circular byte, shift in each row. That means how we do it? We take this 4x4 matrix, okay, which we get as the output of this substitution cipher. Okay, after doing this substitution or byte substitution, replacing the bytes in the table or in the matrix, what we have on that matrix, we are going for circular shift operation. Now, how these circular shift operations are defined? For the first row, there will be no circular shift. For the second row, there will be 1 byte circular shift. And for the third row, it is 2 byte circular shift to left, every time it is left, okay? And for the fourth row, it is 3 byte circular shift to the left, okay? Decrypt does shift to the right. So at the time of decryption, it will happen in the reverse way. And since state is processed by columns, this steps permutes bytes between the columns. Okay, now how does it happen? If you look at this, say, after doing the substitution, the matrix is looking like this. So what is going to happen, for the first row, there is 0 step of shift. So it is, remaining as it is. In the second row, there is left shift with 1 step. Okay, that means 13 is going to be, S13 was here, so it is shifted left by 1 step. S9 is shifted left by 1 shift. S5 is shifted left by 1 shift. And S1, as it is circular shift, came to the end of the row. Okay, so that has happened for the first row. For the second row, there is 2 step shift to the left. So you have S14 here. If it goes 2 step, 1, 2. So at this place, it will come. So you can see S14 came to this place. Okay. Then S14 came to this place. Then S10 is here. So 2 step, 1, 2, it will come at the first location. It came at the first location. And as this is circular shifting to the left, S2 and S6, shifted to here and here. Okay, then circular shift with 3 step for the third row. Okay, so if you do 3 steps, the first element S3 will count as this is a circular shift, 1, 2, 3. So in this place S3 will come, S3 came, then S7, 1, 2, 3. So in this place S3, S7 will come, S7 came here, in the same way, S11 will come here and S15 will come here. Okay, so this is what happens in the shift row step. Next step is mixed column. So mixed column involves a little bit of matrix multiplication. Okay, so each column is processed separately. Then each byte is represented by a value dependent on all 4 bytes in the column. Okay, so each byte is represented by a value which value is dependent on all 4 bytes in the column. And effectively, matrix multiplication in Galois field to the power 8 using prime polynomial m equal to x to the power 8, x to the power 4 plus x to the power 3 plus x plus 1. So this polynomial is basically gives you this matrix. Okay. So this is the matrix you get from this polynomial, and this is your output, or you can say result of your substitution, and this is the matrix you are going to have in the after the multiplication. But there is way to simplify this matrix for AES. Okay, if you go here, you can see how it is happening. This is the matrix you need to multiply with each of the column, that is the gist in the mixed column phase. So this is fixed for each of these four columns you have. Okay, so you pick one column from your output of the substitution phase, this 4x4 matrix. Okay, so first it is picked S0 to S4, the S0 to S3, this column multiplied with this matrix, and we got S0 dash, S1 dash, S2 dash, and S3 dash. And in the same way, we'll take the second column, multiply with this matrix, and we'll have the second column as a result in the resultant matrix. So in this way, 4x4 matrix multiplication you have to do, and you will be able to generate the output of mixed column phase. Okay, once you get this output of mixed column phase, you go for add round key operation. Okay, so what happens in add round key? It is basically JOR state with 128 bit of round key. Okay, again processed by columns and inverse for, so this this is, that means how these round keys are generated, they are processed by the column, some column operation I will show you. Okay, then inverse for decryption is identical, since JOR is own inverse just with the correct round key. That because we all know that JOR is an inversible operation by JOR operation itself. Okay, so this is the thing. And then designed to be as simple as possible. So designed to be as simple as possible. Now, this step, I think it is clear to all. This is nothing but the 128-bit key is generated by the key generator or key expansion algorithm, which 128-bit is simply JORed with this matrix. Okay, and whatever is going to be the result, that is going to be used as a plain text block or an input block for the next round of AES. Okay, and then in this the way it goes for 10 rounds, and final round output is treated as the cipher. And only thing left to discuss is how these 128 bits are generated for every round. We look into that. Okay, so AES key expansion. So it takes 128 bit key and expand into array of 44 or 52 or 32 bit words. So these three options are for three different size of the key. So start by copying key into first four words. Okay, so it start by copying the key into first four words. Okay, then loop creating words that depends on the value in the previous and four places back. Okay, so what does it mean? I will tell you, I'll show you. Okay, in three of the four cases, just JOR used, JOR these together, and every fourth has SBOX plus rotate plus XOR constant of the previous before JOR together. Okay, so these things also I will show you in detail, so don't worry about this right now. Then designed to resist known attacks. Okay, so how does it happen? Initially you have been given with 128 bit key. Now you can see 128 bit key we have represented like this in a 4×4 matrix, and each of the element in the matrix are 8 bits, so total 16 elements, 16 into 8 equal to 128. Okay, so this is the initial key. Okay, now question is that we have to generate, say, for the first round, round key 1. basically we can imagine this way that this place, this 4x4 consecutive, you know, this 4x4 area, we will fill up with the new key generated from this key basically, and we'll fill up this area, this 4x4 area, and which will be used as K1 for the first iteration. Then again another 4x4 area we will generate from this K1, which will be treated as K2 and used for the next iteration, and so on up to the 10th round. 10 times we have to do it. Okay, so how does it happen? First, you can see this 4x4 area is still here, but first what we will do, you need to generate column by column 4 times to generate a 4, to fill up this 4x4 area. Now for to generate the first column of your first key or first round key, what we do, we just copy the previous column, which is the which gives us, see, BA is here, BA is shifted just one step up, 4F is here in the, you know, from up, it is third location, it is shifted one bit up, 4A is at the last location, shifted one bit up, and 03 is came here. So it is basically chosen, the previous column is chosen, and the elements are shifted by one bit upside in circular way. Okay, so one element we got, which will be used to generate this column values, but after that we have to do some operation on it. So what we do, we got this column from here. Okay, then we choose ki-4. So this ki is the column where we are going to fill up. So ki-1 will be this previous column, ki-4 will be this column. Okay, so we'll take this column as well. Okay, we have taken this column here. Okay, and we have this values which is fixed. Okay, this is fixed for AES for the first round key. It will be 01000000. Okay, and we'll jar all these three things together. Okay, we'll jar all these three things together, and we will get a resultant column. And this column elements will be fitted here. Okay, so jar operation with ki-4 column and take the predefined value from Archon table. So this is the predefined value for the Archon table. Okay, and do jar operation again. So the result first column of current round key. So this result is the first column of the current round key. Okay, next, for the second column we have to think about. Okay, now second column is treated as ki, and here it is quite simple as compared to the first column. It takes the ki-1 column, that means the just previous column which we had generated in this column, and it takes ki-4 column as well, and then do jar between this and this column, and the result is placed here in this column. So second column is also generated. So in the this process is repeated for third column and fourth column as well. Okay, so finally we will just get the second round key. Okay, so second round key will be used for the second round, and in this way that third round key and so on, it will keep generating. Okay, so it is clear, I think, to you how these round keys are generated. Okay, so in this way this has the generation will continue. And here if you see the overall structure of AES round, the state represents the input blocks and it in form of bytes. Okay, so in a 4x4 we had represented, so 4 4 4 4. Okay, so 16 bytes are here, which is first goes for sub bytes, then substitution bytes through Xbox. We get the output of the Xbox here, which is another state. Then it goes for shift row. I have shown you how to do the shift row. Shift row gives you this kind of effect, the basically the elements are changed their location horizontally, or their column number they change. Okay, and after doing shift row, you get another state of the block or 128 bit. That 128 bit again goes for mixed column also I have discussed. After doing this mixed column, M is representing mixed column here, you are getting again another state of 128 bit bits. Yes, then you add the round key with each of the bytes. Okay, and finally you get the state. So this goes for this state, this final state goes to the next round. Okay, and if it is the 10th round, this is the final state is the cipher. Okay, so this is what the encryption process of AES. Now decryption of AES. AES decryption is not identical to encryption since steps done in reverse. So it is instead of identical, it is in reverse order. Okay, but can be defined an equivalent inverse cipher with step as for the encryption. So as I have told you, it can be represented in a reverse order, but using inverse of each step with a different key schedule. Okay, works since the result is unchanged when swap byte substitution and shift rows and swap mix columns and add round key. Okay, so it works since the result is unchanged when all these things remains same. Okay, now implications and implementation accept aspects. Can efficiently implement on 8-bit CPU. That is the good thing. The smallest CPU, one of the smallest CPU on which it can be also implemented. Okay, byte substitution, work on bytes using table of 126 entries, and so that is the byte substitution. That's the SBox. It is using SBox. Okay, shift row is simple byte shifting that we have already seen it, and add round key works on jar based operation, only jar, which is also very fast operation. And mixed column requires matrix multiply in Gallus field to the power 8, which works on byte values, can be simplified to use table lookup. So even it is saying it is a matrix, in by theory it is a matrix multiplication, but this matrix multiplication can be replaced with a table lookup, because matrix multiplication is a very complex operation and it is having a high complexity. But if you represent this operation using a table lookup, it will be faster. Okay, then can efficiently implement on 32-bit CPU also. Most of we use 32-bit and 64-bit CPU nowadays. Then redefined step to use 32-bit words, and can pre-compute four tables of 256 words, and then each column in each round can be computed using four table lookups plus four jars. Okay, so this matrix multiplications can be just replaced using four table lookups. Okay, at a cost of 16 KB to store tables. So 16 KB it will store in the cache when it will run. Okay, then designers believes this very efficient. Implementation was a key factor in its selection as AES cipher. So its main key factor for selection as AES was its implementation is very easy to implement. Okay, and finally it is a summary. Have considered the AES selection process, the detail of Rosendahl. The AES cipher is basically public, and looked at the steps in each round and the key expansion and implementation aspects. So these are the things we have basically discussed about AES. Okay, so here a little bit look at the brute force exhaustive search on AES 256. What a researcher had tried to break the AES. So you can see computing power here, and average time to crack using excessive search. Okay, So if you are using a high-end computer, you will need this many years to break AES 256 key, AES with 256 key, to a bit key, you know, these many years. So it is basically equivalent to 27 trillion, 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 trillion years. So you can understand even you know, the latest high-speed machine, almost using that machine, using it is almost impossible to break within a reasonable time some cipher encrypted with AES 256. Okay, then fastest supercomputer available in the world, if you use that, also take this much this many years. 2 billion high, if you have 2 billion high end pieces, so if somehow you have some attacker have collected these many pieces together, then also it will take this many years. And age of the universe itself is 15 billion years. So you can understand what is the complexity of breaking AES using excessive key search. Okay. So here is the link from where I have taken this.